The November battle had neither winners nor losers, with both sides receiving heavy casualties. But while the British managed to re-equip themselves relatively quickly, the Afrika Korps supplies left much to be desired. The Germans were forced to lift the siege and retreat to Tripoli, and the situation in North Africa became stable. During this time, Borg was doing paperwork and errands at Ludwig Cluvel's headquarters. However, peace would not last long, and during a routine flight, Cruel Storch was forced down by the British, and he was taken prisoner. Meanwhile, Army Group Africa launched an offensive with the Germans, inflicting heavy casualties on the British and securing critical supply lines, forcing the Allies to pull the bulk of combat-ready troops to the Egyptian border and leave Tobruk guarded by only a small garrison. This played into the hands of Rommel. Having finally decided to launch another assault, he scheduled it for the morning of June 20th. The success largely depended on the surprise factor and the interaction of the Afrika Korps divisions.
The time has come for decisive action. By 10 o'clock, our tanks will cross defense lines here and here, and then they'll enter the town. The enemy is waiting for an attack from this direction, so every obvious way of advancing will be mined. For this reason, we must force our way to the bay through residential areas. During the entire siege, the Tobruk garrison has only survived thanks to supplies delivered by sea. But now we will cut them off. As soon as we reach the coastline, we will move our artillery into position and open fire on enemy ships. The coastline will be secure, and we will attack the enemy defense lines. Those fortifications may be a real pain, so we'll need to act quickly and decisively. If we can take them down, victory will be ours. The enemy will be demoralized, cut off from reinforcements, and it will be easy to suppress any resistance. We will set out at dawn, and I hope to be watching the sunset from the walls of Tobruk.
You're just in time. An experienced commander is what we need to break through. The Tommies have dug in a few blocks ahead and won't be easy to dislodge. Your squad has cleared the way to the harbor and secured critical artillery. You have shown your worth in recent battles, and soldiers will follow you anyway. Believe me, this is my the left and right of the block are most likely mine. Keep to the initial plan of attack if you want to get to the heart of the minimal casualty.
Infanterie! Fight for those! exact.
Fight for those!
transport sunk. Now they'll think twice about sending another ship into these waters.
Das Ziel ist der TIE Fighter!
Alles destroy British ships!
They've just sunk a third!
Commander, scouts report that enemy ships have altered course and are moving away from the British.
Is a nasty surprise. All right, that's what we'll do. Take 5 men and see where the underpass leads. No heroics. Get to the other side, take a look around, and come straight back. Then we'll decide what to do next.
Erstaunlich. Verstanden.
Jawohl.
Jawohl.
Verstanden!
Feuerschutz! Jetzt!
Oh Mann!
Bloody amazing!
Oh man! I thought we were buried forever. It was like a bomb coming down on our heads. Maybe our guys have finally broken through the wall and we'll be here soon.
Anyway, we can't go back. The explosion has brought down the ceiling. It seems we're inside the fortress now. We have no choice but to advance and act according to the circumstances.
Strange.
There are warehouses here. Only a few people. Nearly every able-bodied man is fighting at the walls. Looks like fuel tanks. Let's try to secure the area. It certainly won't make things worse, and might even do us some good.
Verstanden!
Taking up position.
If Promenade is successful, these warehouses will come in handy for our forces.
Is in the reach zone.
Keep moving.
Verstanden.
Reporting on the successful storm of Tobruk.
We now have warehouses packed with weapons. Our well-deserved bounty is perfect for